What's up, everybody? It's Izzy. I know I haven't made a video in a long time, but today we're going to get that train rolling again, and the topic at hand is attempt selection. In other words, how do you pick the appropriate attempts to do at your powerlifting meet? Now, this is actually a very straightforward and simple topic in terms of execution, at least in my opinion. The hard part is convincing yourself to change your mindset and your approach, because let's face it, most of us got hooked on lifting due to the progress, hitting those big numbers, going after milestones, you know, 2 plates, 3 plates, 4 plates, and we love hitting those things on all those specific lifts. But when it comes to an actual meet, you have to stop thinking about specific lifts, milestones, nice round numbers like 300, 400, 200, and start thinking about building one number, and that one number is your total. And what I mean by all of this and the particulars, I'm going to break down in all the rest of the sections of this video. The first thing that we have to talk about when discussing a powerlifting attempt selection is, what is the point of what we're doing? So if the point of what we're doing is not going after like these nice round numbers, 300 pounds, 200 kilos, 500 pounds, then what are we trying to do? Well, the sport of powerlifting is about the total. It's not about hitting nice round numbers on the individual lifts. It's about having the absolute highest total possible. And while I'm not going to deny that a 3-plate bench or a 6-plate squat is extra sexy, especially compared to, let's say, that same exact lift, if it's only 2.5 kilos less or 5 pounds less, at a meet, all that counts is the total. And you have to change your perspective from one of trying to set PRs on all 3 lifts to looking at all 9 lifts that you have in a meet as one thing. All 9 lifts are one thing that leads to your total. It's not 3 separate disciplines where you're trying to get a PR and do your best on each one of those 3 individually. It is one whole event where you are trying to do your best as a whole on all of them combined together. You have plenty of time throughout your training cycle to go for individual lift PRs and those nice milestone numbers. Okay, you can do that in the gym. At your meet, your goal should be to maximize your total, because at the end of the day, you don't get bonus points for doing a 315 bench or a 140 kilo bench. You don't get any bonus points. It's not going to help you pass your competitors. If your competitor totals 1,000 kilos right on the dot and you total 1,002.5 kilos, guess what? You still win, even though his number is way, way more attractive than yours. The first step to building a big total at a meet is to make sure that you have proper targets for each of the individual lifts. And the only way to do that is to make sure that you're basing your estimated 1 rep max off of something that is realistic. So one of the biggest mistakes that I see people make is they try to base their attempt selection off of like an 8 rep max. And that is just not going to work. The further and further you get away from an actual single, an all-out RPE 10 single, the less accurate these RPE or 1 rep max calculators will be. Even if you're doing a 5 rep max, to me that is still not heavy enough for you to be determining your attempts. What I would actually suggest for determining your attempts is base it on a 3 rep max or less. So let me give you some examples. A 3 rep set where you had 1 rep left in the tank is too light for me personally to be basing my athlete's attempt selections off of. However, if I did a set of 3 at RPE 10, so nothing left in the tank, that's right there. Now, if you did a set of 2 with one rep left in the tank, that would also be fine. Just like a set of 2 at RPE 10 would be fine. And of course, this is the way that I do it with all of my athletes, and you guys can check out the way that I set this up in Programming to Win in the second intermediate program and the advanced intermediate program that is now available in Programming to Win 2. I use submaximal singles. And what I mean by that is singles done at less than RPE 10. So a single at RPE 8 falls right under the category that I'm talking about here, as does a single at RPE 9. And in all of my advanced and late stage intermediate programs, you will find that these are included. And this makes figuring out what your attempts are going to be at a meet extremely easy, because all you have to do is look back to the end of your last block and you can see, okay, what weight did I do for a single at RPE 8? And we can use that to gauge your meat day weight. And it's going to work extremely well because, again, it's very, very close to the actual conditions that you'll be performing at in the meet versus, say, doing, you know, these 5-rep or 8-rep sets. The next thing that I want to talk about is taking intelligent jumps between your attempts and even leading up to your attempts. I mean, I've seen some crazy things over the years. I've been to dozens and dozens of meets at this point. And actually, the craziest thing that I've ever seen was at my very first meet. There was a guy in the warm-up room who was like, he was hitting focus mitts. He had like heavy boxing gloves on. He was screaming and yelling, alternating like jump roping with hitting focus mitts. I mean, I really can't make this up. And he, you know, he'd have somebody like punch him before he got under the bar. And he ended up failing his last warm-up in the warm-up room. And it was just such a bizarre scene because, you know, it was the Washington State Championships. So there was a ton of experienced powerlifters there and nobody had any idea what this guy was doing. I've also seen some other stuff that kind of made me scratch my head. Just people that don't know better. Like I saw somebody that their attempts were literally, they did a 225 bench, a 275 bench, and then a 315 bench. So you see some funny things, and in this section, what I want to talk about is the intelligent way to make jumps between attempts. And the first thing that we're going to start off with is what you start off with, and that is your opener. So the opener is the very first attempt that you do, and in my opinion, there are roughly three primary purposes to the opener. The first and most important one is to make sure that you don't bomb out of the meet. So for those of you who don't know, if you fail to register at least one successful attempt on any of the three lifts, you're automatically out of the meet. You won't be able to compile a total, and you've bombed out, that's what it's called. Now, the second one is to mentally and physically prepare you for the next attempt. This is why we don't open with something ludicrously light, like say 50% of our estimated one rep max. Because if we went from 50% to 90%, that's not going to prepare us for that jump. Both physically and mentally, we wouldn't be ready. And the last one that I would say is that you want to make sure that your opener at least gets a reasonable percentage of your capabilities on the board. So that if for whatever weird reason, let's say you miss something due to rules twice on the second attempt, at least you're not completely out of the meet. Now, I'm not going to lie, getting only 90% of your best on one of the lifts is going to put a huge dent on your total, and it's very hard to come back from that. But if you get at least 90%, you won't be completely out of the meet. One of the oldest pieces of advice in all of powerlifting, at least as far as I can remember, is that you should open with something that you can triple on your worst day. I actually think that's pretty good advice. And what I typically recommend is that you open with a single at RPE 7.5 to 8. Another way to think about that for percentage people is that you're going to want to open at 90% approximately of your estimated one rep max. And while I do adjust this number depending on the lift and how big a lifter is and just a few other factors, 90% is a rock solid starting point for anybody out there. It will work for anybody on all lifts. It can be customized further to make it better, but that is a great point to start. And most of you will not go wrong if you're doing your first meet or your second meet with just opening at 90%. Obviously, the next topic that we're going to address here is your second attempt and what kind of jump you should make to your second attempt. Now, a lot of people believe that your second attempt is where you should start going for PRs, and that really isn't my philosophy at all. Now, that's not to say that I don't have lifters that sometimes PR on their second attempt, but if they do PR on their second attempt, it's because they've made a lot of progress lately. Typically, what I recommend is about a 5% jump, so going up to a single at RPE 9 or so, or about 95% of your estimated one rep max. And of course, there is wiggle room there for individuality, but I don't want to get into that and clutter up the video. So the reason why I say that you should take a moderate jump up to about 95% for your second attempt is because I believe almost the sole purpose of your second attempt is to gauge your third attempt within 5 to 10 pounds or 2.5 to 5 kilos, depending on the lift. That is the function that I use the second attempt for. By using only 95%, you're pretty much guaranteed to at least get your second attempt, assuming that something doesn't go catastrophically wrong with your peaking or that you don't miss a lift twice due to rules. There should never be a meet, in my opinion, where you get less than two attempts on a particular lift, because your second attempt should not be a risk. And that is a big thing that I want to put forward here. The second attempt should not be a big risk. If you go with 95%, it will give you enough information on that day as to how well you're performing that you can gauge your third attempt. I'll get more into discussion of that when I talk about third attempts, but I want you just to consider an example right now that illustrates just how important this one piece of strategy can be. At a powerlifting meet, it's often assumed that the strongest lifter is going to win the meet. But in the case of bad strategy, it's very possible for a lifter who is weaker to beat a lifter who is significantly stronger than them. So I'm gonna edit this video after the fact and put up the math over here, or maybe over here. But consider two lifters. Lifter one has a one rep max of 160 kilos, okay? And they're gonna follow my advice and open at 90%. That's gonna give them a lift of 145 kilos. Let's say that they get that no problem. Now let's say on their second attempt, they decide, hey, I must have made some progress throughout this training cycle, so I'm just gonna take a small risk and go for 162.5 kilos. Let's just say due to whatever reason, this person is not quite as strong as they were hoping on that day, and they fail the lift the first time. Now, once you've increased the weight, you cannot go back down. So for their third attempt, they're gonna be forced to try 162.5 kilos again, and let's say that they fail it again. Now you have a guy who had a one rep max of 160 kilos walking away from bench press with only a 145 kilo result. Now, I want you to consider a guy who has a 155 kilo bench press. Let's say he opens at something significantly lighter than that, okay? In this case, maybe 140 kilos. On his second attempt, he gets that, of course, because it's 90%, he does fine. On his second attempt, he goes for 95%, which is roughly 147.5 kilos. Again, he takes a very conservative number, and he gets that no problem. Now, already, just with his second attempt, by getting 95%, he's beaten a lifter that was 5 kilos stronger than him on the bench press. And that is really a very significant advantage. Medals are often determined by 5 kilos or less. So, even if he doesn't get any of his attempts on the third, he's still gonna beat this guy by 2.5 kilos. Now, let's say he's still smart about the plan and selects a very reasonable third attempt. Maybe he's even extremely conservative and he goes with 152 kilos because he wasn't feeling great that day. He gets the 152 and a half kilos and he beats a guy who had 5 kilo advantage on him heading into the meet, theoretically, by 7.5 kilos. And this is one of the very, very few ways in all of powerlifting that you can gain a competitive advantage through strategy. I mean, there's no interaction with your opponent, right? It's not like wrestling where if you pull somebody, you know, they're pushing back on you. In powerlifting, it's pretty much just you and the bar. But this is one of the very few ways, by being smart about your attempt selection, that you can get an advantage. And I highly recommend that you start thinking this way, thinking about how to build the total as high as possible, rather than always going for PRs individually on each single lift. Obviously, the last jump that we have to talk about is the jump that you make to your third attempt. This is where we go beast mode, right, guys? Not really. The way that I look at this is that you want to make sure that you get your third attempt. I always tell my lifters the following. Only pick a third attempt that you're sure that you can get. Now, if I'm there, obviously, I'll just pick it for them. But the reason why I say this is that I have, at this point, worked with nearly 200 different lifters over 4 years. And psychologically, what I can tell you is that you will always feel better walking away from a lift saying, man, I could have done 2.5 kilos more, versus if you walk away from a lift saying, man, I could have got that if it was only 2.5 kilos less. Not only will you be more physically ready for the next lift, unless it's deadlifts, but if you know, if you don't fail a squat and you don't fail a bench, your motivation remains higher. You have more momentum going into the next lift. And not only that, but you won't feel like you got smacked by a truck the day after the meet, and you can get back into normal training more quickly. You'll look back on the meet as a positive experience. You'll have built your confidence even higher, and you'll know that you're gonna beat those numbers again next time because you left a little bit on the platform. And I think that's the big mentality switch that a lot of people need to make, is that it's better to leave a little bit on the platform than it is to go all out and miss attempts left and right. So what I would actually suggest for your third attempt is to base your third attempt on your second attempt. And this is where RPE can be very, very useful. You guys know that I'm all about auto-regulation. I use it in all of my programs. So at a meet, it's no different. If your second attempt was a little harder than expected, I would recommend not going for 100% of your estimated one rep max. In that case, I would recommend going for, you know, in that 97 to 98% range, we'll just say 97.5%, and that way you can be sure that you're gonna get your third attempt, you're gonna walk away with the highest percentage of your capability on that day as is possible, thus ensuring you'll have the best total possible on each and every lift. Now, if the second attempt went just as expected, then you can just go for 100%, or, you know, maybe slightly less than that, or whatever you think, whatever you feel very, very confident that you're going to get. Now, let's just say that you smash your second attempt. I'm not so rigid that you shouldn't increase the weight at that point. If you smash your second attempt and it's way easier than usual, I think you can feel safe going for 102.5% or something like that. You know, 102 to 103. If you do that, and you've already proven with your second attempt that your performance is very good that day, that your readiness is high, that the peak worked extremely well, I see no reason why you can't go for a slightly higher third attempt. But if this is based on fact. It's not based on a nice round number goal that you wrote down before the meet. It's not because you're gonna go for 315 instead of 311. It's because your second attempt proved that you're strong that day. And it makes sense to try to get the most out of yourself that you can once you've already proven that it's there. The last thing that I want to cover here is what to do if you miss an attempt. This is such a key thing. I probably should have brought it up earlier, but let's talk about it now. In my opinion, whenever you miss an attempt due to a rules violation, you should repeat that attempt. Now, I know that sometimes people have gambled on this and it's worked out for them, but just as many times, if you miss your first attempt due to a rules violation, you could miss your second attempt due to a lack of strength. And if that ends up happening, there's no way for you to recover, okay? Like, you can't lower the weight, so the only thing you can do is repeat that weight again, and this is the number one way, besides injury, that people have to drop out of meets due to bombing out, okay? It's such a common mistake where people will forget to wait for the rack command on squats or bench, or, you know, they don't wait for the down command on deadlift, or they drop the deadlift. There's a lot of classic beginner mistakes out there. And my advice to you is to make sure that you are practicing these things in the week leading up to the meet so that they don't happen to you. That's A. But B, if it does happen to you, don't panic and don't be risky, okay? Just repeat the attempt. Now, of course, there's gonna be exceptions to this. You know, like if you're in the middle of nationals and you're competing for a podium spot, this is a meet that happens once a year. So maybe you do feel like it's necessary to make that gamble. But the vast majority of you that I'm talking to are not gonna be in that situation. You're just gonna be at a local meet that you've signed up to do the best that you can. And in that situation, you should always repeat your attempts. All right, the last thing I wanna do here is give you a quick recap of everything that I've said to turn this into a full system for how to properly pick your attempts at a powerlifting meet. So number one is that you need to base your estimated one rep max off of something realistic. And that means using a 3 rep max or less, okay? The second is that you need to have intelligent jumps between your attempts. So for your first attempt, for your opener, start with roughly 90%. For your second attempt, jump up to roughly 95%. And for your third attempt, you're gonna base your third attempt on how your second attempt went. If your second attempt was harder than usual, do roughly 97.5% for your third attempt. If your second attempt went just about as expected, then do 100% for your third attempt. If your second attempt was easier than normal, you can go as high as 102.5% on that third attempt. So use auto-regulation to make the final decision. Of course, remember to repeat all missed attempts. And the last little thing that I will leave you with is this. it, remember that it is always a better feeling to say, man, I could have done 2.5 kilos more versus saying, man, I could have done it if it was 2.5 kilos less. You'll feel better physically, mentally, and more importantly, perhaps, in the first scenario, you're only leaving 2.5 kilos on the table. If you miss your third attempt because it's 2.5 kilos too heavy, you lose all of the kilos between that attempt and your second attempt, which could easily be as much as 5 to 10 to 15 kilos, depending on how strong you are and what lift that we're talking about. All right, guys, that's all I have to say in this video. Hope you enjoyed it, found it informative, and hopefully it'll be useful to you at your next meet. If you haven't already heard, I have released a revised and updated edition of Eating to Win 2. You can find all the changes that I made in a link in the description box. And I have also re-released Programming to Win. It's now Programming to Win 2. All new programs throughout the book. The novice program has been completely updated and revised. So has the intermediate programs. And the book now contains an advanced program for you guys as well. So if you want to learn more about that, again, check out the description box. If you have any questions about this video, leave them below, and hopefully I'll be able to get back to you. As always, have a nice day, and good luck with your training. Peace.